Are you suffering from bleeding in the gums? Do you experience loosening of teeth? Do you think you have gum diseases? This video is an answer to all of your problems. We all have bacteria in our mouth. We fail to maintain our oral hygiene without regular brushing and without regular flossing. We tend to get deposits which firmly attaches to the surface of the tooth. These deposits create a habitat for the already existing bacteria to multiply in a larger extent. When these bacteria tend to release their toxic products, directly damages your gum tissues. The gum diseases are definitely a serious problem because it not only affects your oral health, it affects your entire systemic health as well, including diabetes and hypertension. The bacteria and these soft deposits together constitute to what we call as plaque. This plaque builds up within the tooth. Bacteria which is present within the plaque also increases. In turn leads to inflammation. You tend to experience bleeding, redness and gums being swelled. Gingival inflammation is known as gingivitis. Treatment during this stage is essential to prevent the progression of the gum disease to what we call as periodontitis. Final diagnosis is made, the treatment plan will be to eliminate and to remove the entire plaque deposits, which is the main causative agent which is causing your gum diseases.
This is a gum disease which basically causes damage to the soft tissue and the supporting bone which surround the tooth, which make the tooth firm into the jaw. Characterized by mobility of your teeth, food impaction and a vague, constant or intermittent kind of pain, which treatment of periodontitis is basically divided into two broad categories. One is surgical treatment and one is non-surgical treatment. Non-surgical periodontal therapy, it's going to remove the deposits which are present on the surface and beneath the gum. So we are going to remove that with our hand instrument or ultrasonic scalers we can use. We call it scaling and root planing. Once we remove all these deposits, we can make sure that the gum is returning back to its healthy condition. The problem is not subsided or deposit local antibiotics directly into the gum so that it will eliminate the bacteria from there. In surgical part, we are going to raise flap, which means we are going to separate gums from the teeth surface. By doing that, we are directly able to see what kind of bone loss is present. So if the condition is treatable, we are going to use different kinds of bone graft that ultimately lead to the restoration of the lost bone in the long term. And we have placed the bone graft into the lost bone and we have removed other particulate and unwanted deposits from the tooth surface and beneath the tooth surface. So once this is done, we are going to reposition the gum to adjacent to the tooth surface and suture it. This procedure completes the periodontal flap surgery. Once we have done with the surgery, we are going to call patients after 15 days of calling the patient for the further evaluation.